Hello everybody, thank you for tuning in to check out this video, and in today's video I will be doing a requested system test by MoparFam300c on my Silent Night 6808 addressable fire alarm system. So let's go ahead and get started. Alright, and so for the next that he has requested, coming up here for the first notification appliance, he requests the Gentex SHG. It didn't tell me which one, so I just put my second generation SHG up. And it's being coded to code 3 by the panel. And the strobe is fixed 1575 candela. And then coming over here for NAC2, he requested the Wheelock NS, which the strobe is 15 candela, and it's on its default code 3 horn with a Wheelock sync. And down here for the first conventional pull station, he requested the RMS1T. And then coming over here for the second conventional pull station, he requested the Edwards 278B1120 underneath the stumper. For today's addressable pull station, we will be pulling the SK Pull SA. For one of the detectors today, we will be activating my other Silent Night SK Heat Rate of Rise with my magnet. And for the other detector today, we will be activating my SK Photo-W with the smoke saver. And for our supervisory system today, we will be activating the yellow pull station. All right, and before we begin, we're going to go ahead and make an announcement over the microphone of the VEC2550, saying that we are about to set off the system. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? We will be setting off the system momentarily. Please disregard all signals until further notice. This is only a test. Again, we will be setting off the system momentarily. Please disregard all signals until further notice. Again, this is only a test. Thank you for your cooperation. And just a heads up, both the horns and the strobes will be out of sync, so headphone users, I recommend that you please turn down your volume. All right, and to start off today's test, we're going to go ahead and pull the single action addressable pull station. Here we go, in 3, 2, 1. That is quite loud, especially the NS, but as you can see, both strobes are still flashing since I have the SHG on two-wire operation and the Wheelock NS on Wheelock sync. And of course, the strobe on the SPSR is still flashing because it's on the same strobe circuit with the SHG. Now we're going to come over here. We're going to re-alarm again with the Edwards 278B1120. Here we go.
May I have your attention, please? Please proceed to the next exit and leave the building. Do not re-enter the building unless directed to do so by the proper authorities.
As usual, you can still hear the horn going inside the Wheelock NS when it's on Wheelock sync. I don't know why it does that, but it just does. All right, now we're going to go ahead and go and reset those two pull stations. And so to reset the Edwards 278B1120, I'm just going to take my key, turn it like that, put the switch down, lock it back up just like that. And for the Silent Night pull station, I'm just gonna open it up just like this. See, here's the inside of it. Close it back up like that. And now I'm gonna go into the main fire alarm control panel and I'm gonna hit system reset. All right, next up, we're gonna re-alarm the system again with the RMS-1T. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. And to reset the RMS-1T, I'm just going to take my Simplex B key, open it up like this, flip the handle back up, close it just like that. And you see the monitor module is red. That's where the pull station has been activated. And so when I press system reset, the monitor module will start to blink green again. And so we're just going to go ahead and hit system reset. All right, now for the detectors. We're just gonna go ahead and spray some smoke saber at the sk-heat-ror-w, and it'll go ahead and activate. The LEDs will turn steady red. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Should be enough. There's that. Here's the strobes flashing again. And now we're just going to go up to my other SK heat detector. We're going to activate it with my magnet testing tool. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. The alarm indicator on the test switch is hooked to the same control module with the strobe circuit, so it remains lit when I silence the system. All right, now I'm going to go into the panel. I'm going to hit system reset. All right, now we move on to the supervisory. Now, for the supervisory today, we will be pulling the yellow pull station. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. to see no audible silence on the alert commander since I have it on two-wire operation. Now, to reset the position, set my TAP 45 key, open it up just like this, just like I did with the 278B1120. Close it back up just like that. And now I'm going to go into the panel again. I'm going to hit system reset. Alright, and before I end the video, let's do a quick fire drill on the panel. So, when I do the fire drill, the SHG will sound a continuous instead of code 3. And no sync on the Wheelock NS. So, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to press the drill button. I'm going to press enter. Here we go. This is going to be loud. And before we end our system test, we're going to go ahead and make one more announcement over the microphone saying that we have finished.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? We have finished testing the life and safety system at this time. If you hear any fire alarm signals from this point forward, please evacuate to your nearest assembly point. Again, we have finished testing the life and safety system at this time. If you hear any fire alarms from this point forward, please evacuate to your nearest assembly point. Thank you for your cooperation, and have a great day.
Alright everybody, thank you all for watching this video. Special shout out to MoparFam300c for requesting this setup. Be sure to check him out. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. Have a great day, and I will see y'all in the next video.